Jake the Film Guy here, microbudgeter.com, and in today's video we're going to be talking about the essential checklist for when you do a live event. Now that could be a wedding, that could be a bar mitzvah, a birthday, a corporate event. They're all going to be celebrating something, and if you're hired to go and cover that event, then there are several items that you need to take care of, both from a business standpoint and from a practical standpoint, before you get your feet wet. Number one, make sure you have the work signed off. If at the very least you only have discussed rates, get that approved in writing from the person that's hiring you to do the work. Additionally, I would hold off, and this is point number two, on handing over the footage and explain this in writing until either your deposit is met, the bill has been paid, or at the very least you do have that signature that says, these are my rates, this is what I will be charging in my invoice. And there may be some flexibility in your invoicing because you may get to the site and then 2 days into the event, they realize, well, we need you for two more days rather than just these 2 days. Be flexible, but have things in writing. Now, as far as the actual hardware goes for this event, number one, you wanna make sure that you have a good camera that can shoot in low light. If you haven't been to the environment before, it's best to bet on the safe side and have something that can handle any environment and shoot a good clean image, regardless of how well lit or poorly lit the room is. Item number two, and this is also just as important, you wanna make sure that you are using some kind of eyepiece or viewfinder in conjunction with your camera should your event take you outside for any reason where the sunlight is blinding. You also wanna have a great zoom lens, something that's able to go between wide and punched in and still give you a sharp and reliable and somewhat fast image. You need a tripod. I cannot state this enough, but it needs to be something that is easily deployed as well as levels easily when you are moving from surface to surface. Beyond that, make sure you have several memory cards. You don't wanna get there and then have one of your memory cards crap out. And you definitely, definitely don't wanna fill up your memory cards and not have anywhere to back up that footage when you need to erase or format the memory card. So bring several. Don't be the amateur, be the professional that's prepared for the worst case scenario. You also wanna have a slider to add some cinematic shots. If you have a gimbal, that's great. Bring it too, but at the very least, bring your slider and a shoulder rig. Well, you may not use the shoulder rig, but it's nice to have it just in case you have to do something that's very run and gun and the tripod's not practical. And for whatever reason, you can't stabilize with your gimbal very quickly. So a shoulder rig is a good fallback option. You also wanna have, and this is number eight, a good phantom mic, and I mean a phantom powered mic. So excuse me, audio purists, but you need something to capture those on-screen moments where people wanna do a shout out or make some kind of statement in front of the camera. Beyond those things, you also need cans or earbuds to listen in to your audio. You additionally want to have loads and loads of batteries in case they crap out, in case they fail to maintain a charge, in case you can't charge them, or worse, in case you simply have no place to recharge them. I did say you can't charge them. Well, that would be a specific example of that. Bring lots of batteries. You need a power bank. You cannot guarantee that you're going to have lots of outlets to recharge and keep everything running smoothly. Make sure you bring your power bank with you. Adapters as well. Everything from the USB to wall power adapter to your charging cables. Bring everything that you could possibly need. And as it goes without saying, you need your laptop. Now, you may think, oh, I don't need my laptop. Yes, you do. You want to be able to check your footage to make sure you're hitting your critical focus and that you have a secondary option to back up footage, which leads me to a good old reliable solid state drive. Bring that and back up footage throughout the day. You need to be checking your footage. You need to be backing up your footage. Don't just hang on to the memory cards and assume that everything's hunky-dory. And last but not least, for your essential checklist, you need to have food and beverage. Now, at a live event, there's more than likely gonna be food, but you cannot guarantee that you're gonna be able to enjoy any of that food or beverage. And the last thing you need is low blood sugar. Take care of yourself, get plenty of sleep the night before. Make sure that you eat a balanced meal before and afterwards. You wanna make sure you're eating quality calories and not just Cheetos and garbage all day, because I promise you, live events will pack a punch. We're talking like Ivan Drago, Rocky IV, kind of packing a punch. You need to make sure that you're putting good stuff into the tank so that you can run all day long if need be. Additionally, on top of your personal care, you want to make sure you're brushing your teeth and bringing gum. You don't want to blast people with your dragon breath. And last but not least, at these live events, you have a chance to network. People are going to be curious about who you are, what you're doing. Some people will be scared and they'll run for the hills when they see you with the camera, but others will want to engage you. Obviously, you're there to cover the event, but smile, shake hands, introduce yourself, and if they ask for a business card, be ready to hand one out. You need to have a good killer 8-second pitch to maintain attention and to hook their attention. More importantly, if you need help with that, check out the post on networking. Now, I said last but not least, and that's actually a lie. Very, very last detail is cloud storage. Now, this goes hand in hand with the article or video on client care, customer service when the job is done. You want to have a good cloud storage solution, something that your client can go to indefinitely when the job is done and pull files from their footage. And if you want, give them a chance to upload footage. I don't know why, but it's nice to have that flexibility. I recommend pCloud. I've been using it for my clients. And if you want, you can try it for free for 30 days using the link below. Until next time, keep creating with the King. If you found this information useful, who is it in your life that is doing live events? Share this video with that person, and I will see you next time. Wait, bonus. Go to the site if you need help with creating a media production proposal. It is in the link for this blog post. I have revised my own media production proposal. The agreement has simplified the sales process. It doesn't have as much head-scratching legalese and jargon that sends people running for the hills. Take a look at it, use it, tear it up. It is a template for your media productions. God bless.